When I asked my precalculus students this equation, many of them didn't know where to start. I think the reason is because we have the natural log of x in the power, and then we have two of them. And this right here has three terms. However, I'll tell you though, this right here is actually not so bad. It's just a hidden quadratic equation. What do I mean? Let me show you. The key is this term right here, we have 4 to the ln x power. And if you compare this and that, 4 and 2, that's suspicious. 4, it's 2 to the second power. So I just want to write that down right here. Note, if you look at the 4 as 2 to the second power, and then raise that to the ln x power, we can multiply the exponents, and that will be the same as 2 to the 2 ln x power. And you can actually look at this as 2 to the ln x power, and then square. In another word, this right here is actually the square of this middle term. So that means we actually have a quadratic equation, but it's just going to be in terms of 2 to the ln x power. So I'm actually going to write this. Let's see which form that we like. I'm just going to put it down like this. We have 2 to the ln x power and then square plus 2 to the ln x and then minus 6, that's equal to 0. Oh, by the way, many of them could guess the answer. The answer is E. Yeah, but you have to show work. Anyways, we have a quadratic equation. And again, they are all the same because you can multiply the exponents ln x times 2. It's still that. Yeah. Right here, I will factor it for you guys. I will factor it with the tic-tac-toe method to make it super clear. So what times 4 give us 2 ln x squared? Well, it's just 2 to the ln x power times 2 to the ln x power. And then what times 4 give us negative 6? Together they add up to 1. Yeah, the coefficient right there is 1. I'm going to use 3 and negative 2. Okay, check. This times this, we get negative 2 times 2 ln x power. And then this times that, we get 3 times 2 to ln x power. Combine like terms. Negative 2 plus 3 is just positive 1, so this right here checks. So that means we can factor it. We get 2 to the ln x power plus 3 times 2 to the ln x power minus 2 being 0. We can continue now. Put this equals 0. And then put this equals 0. And then solve them individually. Okay, subtract 3 to both sides. 2 to the ln x power equals negative 3. Now, here's the deal. When we have a positive constant raised to a variable power, can that ever be negative? No. If you have ln x equal to negative 3, that's solvable, right? It's just e to the negative 3 power. That's okay. But this right here, it's impossible. So I should say impossible with real numbers. So I'm just say no real solution. And in precalculus, we just don't talk about the complex solution in this kind of situation. So just ignore that. For this right here, so add 2 to both sides. Right? Add 2 to both sides. Okay. The bases are the same. Very nice. This is the same as 2 to the first power. So that means the exponents have to be equal. So we just have to consider ln x being 1. And then we can do e to this power and e to that power. So x is just equal to e. Yeah, just like that. So the answer is e. That's it.